Let me tighten that up for you, Gary.
Yeah, I'm not producing a video without you here, Jake. But no, I had a bit of a trouble. That kept slipping, that did. So I take it off. I've made a lovely thread, though. I must admit, this thread is amazing. Even I'm impressed with it, and I'm not easily impressed. So if I want to get it off here, oh, you are a strong lad, aren't you? That's absolutely wrecked.
Yeah, you've made a mess of that, Gary. Don't worry, I'll show you how I can sort that out. So as you can see, you've made a mess of that, Gary.
Well,
I'm gonna have to sort that out.
Yeah, a little bit of a mess, yeah. So what are you gonna do then for me?
So obviously you've not tidied it up enough. You need to go back to the gym tonight. You've took all the zinc coating off this this conduit here. So as we did in a previous video over here, look, where we use some zinc galvanising spray on our exposed threads, I'm gonna do the same again. So okay. I'm gonna go ahead and get my PP on.
Okay, so yeah, so PP on. Are you gonna leave it in this state, or are you gonna have to file it up before you start?
No, I'm gonna give it a file before I spray it, yeah.
Because there's a few little raised rough edges on there, isn't there? So we're gonna file those off. And of course, we're removing that zinc, which is obviously offering the protection against corrosion while we're doing this. And it's a case of spraying it back in. Now, if you're watching this and you're at college, often you don't get a chance to respray your conduits at college, do you? But this is something that definitely needs to be done when you're obviously on site.
So just a light coating. There we go.
Okay, so let's have a little closer look. So we've managed to replace the zinc that was missing by spraying it with a zinc galvanised spray. Okay, so that's it, job done.
That's it, job done, leave that to dry.
He's full of it, isn't he? Top tips, that is. So I didn't have my round jaw vise on my conduit tight enough, and I damaged that zinc, which is on the outside of the conduit, preventing it from corroding. And you showed us there to file it down and spray it up before we leave that job. What have you got there?
That's right, Gary. And we looked at this in a previous video where I did a running coupler. We had our exposed threads, and we showed how to use some zinc galvanizing spray on those exposed threads to stop that corroding.
Yeah. If you're watching this year at college, you're probably thinking, I don't get an opportunity at college to actually spray back my conduit when I've damaged it. What's your thinking behind that?
Yeah, Gary, that's usually down to storing it and cost regulations.
Yeah, it is, and I think it's also down to the fact that maybe one or two students would spray other things maybe than their conduit, okay? But as always, where do we go next in this series? It's down to you. Leave the feedback below on what you want to see. If you haven't checked out our playlist already with all our videos on conduit, we'll also leave that in the description. And as always, those comments will be got back by Jake, every single one of them personally. Well done, Jake. I like that.